Welcome back to PepsiCo Foods Podcast, Recipe for Success. I'm your host, Jillian Emmons.
And I'm your new co-host, Krish Patel, and I'm so excited to join you. This podcast is brought to you by PepsiCo employees who share their unique career experiences with the goal to inspire you.
By the end of each episode, we hope you'll learn something new to add to your own recipe for success.
Are you ready to keep on dreaming? I'm here to push you.
This is part one of our two-part series, and we are joined by Marisa Perez and Amber Benton, two of our wonderful PepsiCo leaders.
Marisa and Amber bring so much experience across the business, and we can't wait to learn from them. So let's jump right in. To start things off, we're just going to kick it to you. If you can introduce yourself, your current role, and how many years you've been at PepsiCo, and then we're going to chat more.
All right. Well, I'm Marisa Perez, as you mentioned. My current role as of literally this week or maybe next week is Senior Vice President of our e-commerce sales and commercialization for PepsiCo. And this year is actually going to be a milestone year for me, 20 years with the company.
Wow. Oh, Congrats. Well, we'll be talking more about that. Yeah. Amber?
Hello, everyone. I'm Amber Benton. This will be 17 years for me with PepsiCo, and I'm currently the Vice President of Human Resources for Frito-Lay U.S. Supply Chain.
Amazing. Well, thank you both for being here.
Yeah, it's good to be here.
So, Marisa, tell us more. What is this promotion? What does this mean for you? Bring us in a little bit.
Oh, I'm super excited about this new role, new adventure. I'm constantly learning and growing at PepsiCo, but now I get to go into the e-com space. And as you guys know, e-commerce is just such an important space for the company, growing so fast, definitely where the consumers are, you know, looking for convenience online. And so I know, at least for myself, it's definitely something I'm very passionate about. So it's great that I get to lead PepsiCo sales in this space. Since it's a PepsiCo role, I also get to bridge back over to the beverage side. I spent my first 8 years with the company in beverages, and then my last 10 plus years on the food side. So it's actually great that I get to kind of have the holistic PepsiCo portfolio again and rekindle those relationships in beverages and get back into that business, as well as do more on the sales side for the PFNA side. So it's great, just, you know, all in PepsiCo and sales, new exciting customers, Amazon, Instacart. Working with the Kroger.coms and all the regionals as they build out their .com capabilities.
Yeah.
So it's a really exciting space.
And well-deserved.
Oh, yes. Thank you.
Congratulations. Thank you. Big, big congratulations. So if we back up or rewind, where did it all begin at PepsiCo?
Well, for me, it actually is like way back, PBG. Like, people are like, what's that? Pepsi Bottling Group is where I came into the organization as the multicultural marketing manager.
Okay.
And so kind of grew up from the field organization in both marketing roles and then moved into sales roles for the beverage side. I actually had a role where I was based out of New York, running all of multicultural marketing for all of beverages. And we were doing a lot of Power of One. And so that's where I started getting to know the Frito team. And they were like, hey, we really like working with you. You want to come to Texas? And so in 2011, 2012 is when I moved over to the food side of the business at Frito-Lay as the director of the Tostitos brand. Cool. And then kind of grew up in the marketing organization here at Frito and realized that the organization didn't know that I had done sales roles also. And I was really passionate about a general management career track. So I kind of went on my little meet and greet tour and introduced myself and more of my background to other senior leaders, and then moved into sales on the Frito side, and actually had eventually the awesome pleasure of working with the fabulous Amber Benton when I got to run one of our largest region for Frito. Back then it was called the South Central region.
Okay.
And Amber was my HR partner. And still today is my coach personal mentor.
Yeah, we co-coach each other.
But anyway, so running the region. And so then most recently I was the senior vice president of commercialization for PF&A and kind of got to bring together my marketing, sales, and field experience into the growth office. So it's just been an awesome journey, and I can't believe almost 20 years, but that's part of the magic of PepsiCo. You just keep learning and growing, and time flies when you're having fun.
Yes. Oh,
absolutely. So true.
And I heard a little PepsiCo buzzword in there. So when we say power of one, what does that mean and why is that important to us?
Power of one is basically the food and beverage side of the business coming together, because we know not only are there so much synergies between our portfolio, but when we work together, we actually can amplify the results and drive better results for the company and deliver more of what the consumer and shopper are looking for. So it's kind of a win-win for everyone when we really join forces in the power of our PepsiCo portfolio.
Very cool.
All right. Awesome. All right. Well, Amber, how did your career at PepsiCo begin and how has it evolved?
Yeah. 17 years ago, which is crazy to think about, actually, I started in the Orlando manufacturing site on the Frito-Lay side, leading HR for the site. I was an experienced hire. So moving to Florida and first time in manufacturing, it was quite an eye-opening experience. But from there, I moved on to other roles within HR in the old Florida region when we had 16 regions. And then before kind of leaving Florida, led the HR site there in Orlando and brought up an offsite warehouse and reset the talent strategy, did some really cool things. And I had the opportunity the first time to come to Texas as the HR director for national sales. That's actually the first time Marisa and I crossed paths. I was supporting Walmart and you were doing marketing?
Yeah, Walmart shopper marketing.
Yeah, Walmart shopper marketing. And I was like, she's cool. I like her. I wonder if we'll ever work together. And, you know, fast forward, I went to New York as a senior director for global diversity and engagement, which was a really cool opportunity to see PepsiCo outside of the U.S. And a lot of the same social concerns, just how they resonate in the communities outside the U.S. It was a really eye-opening experience. And we had just named our commitment around women at the time. So some really important and impactful programming for women, both domestic and abroad. I'm really proud of the work that I did when I was there and got to come home to Frito, moved back to Texas, and that's when I was the senior HRD for then South Central. Marisa was one of three RVPs that I supported in that time. But we did some really cool stuff. Yeah. We had COVID together.
We had hurricanes.
We had hurricanes like
category
six or eight,
seven named storms.
Okay. Named hurricanes. Yeah. Yeah. So when they name them, they're serious.
Yeah. We had category four, Laura, together during COVID.
It was fun. Awesome. And then I had the opportunity to come into headquarters again. You know, post-COVID, we realized the world had changed and our refocus on our frontline associates. So it was a really cool opportunity to reset our strategy for the future of frontline, working across both sales and supply chain. And also, PepsiCo was redefining the future of talent. So a lot of work across beverages as well, both for salaried and frontline individuals. And then about a year ago, I stepped into this role leading HR for supply chain. So it felt a little bit like a homecoming. Mm-hmm. I still know how we make and move a chip, which is cool. But in the era of modernizing our supply chain, there's some really cool, I think, an exciting transformation underway. And my team gets to be a part of that and work with our teams to make sure we deliver.
Very cool. Wow. So many. That's some like pivotal moments.
Yes. Yeah.
And that's vital to the business. So kudos to you all. And in both of your descriptions, obviously a lot of career opportunities and movement. What personally has made you open to not only moving roles, but even locations and where you've lived and worked?
Well, for me, it's been kind of the balance of both the professional opportunities, but also what's important to me personally. So early in my career, and part of why I do look back and say how blessed I am to have diversity of functions, is because I wasn't able to relocate. You know, my family was in Southern California. I had a stepson who we were, you know, committed to being a part of his life, and we weren't going to leave, you know, Southern California because of that. And so, yes, did I have opportunities to, you know, move or advance my career more quickly? Absolutely. But the personal was too important. And so it's definitely a blessing that I then got, you know, marketing and sales experience in Southern California. When we ultimately were able to move, when my stepson went off to college, then you say yes. Then all of a sudden the personal dynamics change and you can lean into some of the professional opportunities. And so I definitely feel that you know, when you're true to yourself and what really is important to you, there's no regrets, right? And PepsiCo is a company where there are always so many opportunities to learn and grow. And sometimes, you know, slow and steady wins the race versus people who are just so excited about the next promotion and they just want to, you know, move up as quickly as possible. For me, my experience has been actually I've learned the most and had more doors open up from long-term, higher-level jobs because I took time to have more of what we call kind of the lattice approach, more lateral moves, differentiating experiences that I wouldn't be in the role I'm in today had I not had those experiences earlier in my career.
Right. What would you say, Amber?
I think it's the mix of opportunity and preparation and honestly, courage. There's some big risks that you take when you move your family cross country. I was either, you know, first time we came to Texas, my oldest was 3 months. When we moved to New York, I was pregnant. When we came back, she was sub two, right? So these were big moments. My husband also has a demanding career, right? So the balance has always been imbalanced, quite frankly, because it's just not perfect, right? But I think to Marisa's point, being centered on what's important to you and your family, we've been able to navigate through it all. Now, we look back, I don't know how. I that's probably a follow-up question. Like, girl, I don't know. I mean, you know, thank God for Alvin Benton. Like, I just...
Well, there's truth in that. Your partner
is essential, and your network is essential, and your truth with your, you know, I've always had great bosses that were understanding, and I've always had great business partners that were understanding. I try to approach my career. I am where I am while I'm there, which means I'm doing the things to account for home and work so they can be in harmony as much as possible. And that has given me freedom really to express myself both personally and professionally because I feel like I've accounted for the other. I think the other piece, you know, as you grow up in your career and you start having expanded responsibility that usually comes with teams of people that are able, you know, you giving them the tools to be successful in the work that they own, the courage, you know, and then also just the space to, you know, safely say what they need as well. So it's the juxtaposition of we're hard charging, we've got big deliverables, we're very excited about delivering the business, and then life. Mm-hmm. You know, and as those things come at you, sometimes you're dealing day to day, sometimes you're dealing week to week. You know, you might get to look out across the month, right, if you're lucky. But I think it's just been a combination of all those things over the course of, quite frankly, I say I'm surprised it's 17 years because it really has not felt like 17 years. Every opportunity was so exciting, so challenging. The dynamics of our organization is so interesting that it feels fresh, fresh and fast, and keeps me interested and engaged. And, you know, kind of all those things added together has been what's enabled my career.
Don't forget to check out part two of our conversation with Amber and Marisa to learn how they stay true to themselves at work while also juggling their personal goals in life. Be sure to hit that follow button on Spotify so you know when our next episodes are live.